In the petition of the Uganda Muslim Supreme Council, Parliament was asked to intervene and ensure that government fulfills the compensation of 70 billion shillings for the Chitante land and other ranches. The compensation has remained outstanding, and now Mufti Sheikh Shaban Ramadan Mubaje wants government to offset it in this financial year.
More than 12 billion shillings, that for the ranches. Right, Honorable, here we have a land close to 15 acres where this golf club takes part of it. We have a running title in the name of Uganda Muslim Council, but KCC went ahead to sub-lease to developers. So when we talked to His Excellency the President, he directed that we be compensated as Uganda Muslim Council.
Although the Muslim community is happy with the recent laws which Parliament passed to operationalize Islamic banking, Mubaje says they're not happy with the fact that Parliament repealed the requirement of the Central Sharia Advisory Council to regulate Islamic banking. They now want this to be reconsidered.
The Central Sharia Advisory Council does not have any impact on the Islamic banking. Each bank is going to carry out the banking activity on its own, with its own board. No more issue of, because we don't have the Sharia board in place, that the banking is not going to take place. All we are waiting for is an assent from the president.
In the same meeting with the speaker, Sheikh Mubaje called on Parliament to formulate a law to legalize the right of Muslims to slaughter animals. Mubaje noted that the exclusivity of Muslims on slaughtering will protect people from consuming non-halal meat.
Now in it has created confusion. People are saying the Muslims are the one who's slaughtering, but others are saying there is no law, there is no such thing. Now it has created confusion. Muslims have never made a mistake in their way of providing halal meat for the consumers. But those who are fighting it, they have ill intentions of bringing meat which is not good to the public.
In the same vein, Muslims called for more inclusiveness in government programs by ensuring affirmative inclusivity of at least a Muslim on every board and government commission.
Right, Honorable, we continue to request for affirmative inclusivity for at least a Muslim on every commission. I think that one has been answered on board and in other government programs with the Liberate Action for Muslims, letters of support with bilateral and multilateral agencies. We request for your help in connecting our land Muslims to jobs at both national and international levels.
In her remarks, the Speaker of Parliament applauded the Muslim leaders for standing with Parliament in passing the anti-homosexuality bill and for always praying for the institution.
First, we want to thank you so much. The anti-homosexuality act now came with a lot of challenges, but we are ready to move on with those challenges. We are being fought left, right, center, but we'll continue with those challenges. Even the Islamic banking itself, we got a lot of resistance, and there was a misconception that when you bring the Islamic banking, the Muslims are coming with something else. It's not banking per se.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.